ஸ்வபாவ சின்மயானந்தம் கிருபா பூர்ணம் ஜகத்பதிம் ஹரிஷட் வர்க்க ஜேதாரம் நித்யானந்த குரும் பஜே. ஸ்வபாவ சின்மயானந்தம் கிருபா பூர்ணம் ஜகத்பதிம்.
Maybe one more question. With this I'll end. What is the happiness? Yes, your question. Please, you can put your question also. I'll answer both together.
I'm having a doubt that what kind of practice we should adopt to progress in the spiritual
path. Okay.
Like we don't have any guru.
Two things. What is happiness and guru? You see, the idea, let me be very honest. I always tell people in our ashram, whenever people ask me about this guru and all these things, I tell them, there is a beautiful example. If you allow the calf, it will go and be with the cow only for 10 minutes, but the calf will drink the milk and come out. The bee, fly, which is sitting on the cow 24 hours, it will drink only the blood. So you can have guru, but just drink his blood, give headache to him. And you can be away from guru and drink only milk whenever you go near him. It is not being near a guru's physical presence. I don't think that plays any major role in the seeking. It is the depth of seeking that plays a major role. Ramakrishna very beautifully says, surrender to anything. Surrender is important, not to what you surrender. If you surrender, even a stone can become God and guide you. That's what happened in Ramakrishna's life. It's just a black stone, 3 feet black stone. If you go and see, it looks very funny. This 3 feet black stone showed this Ramakrishna the whole world. The Kali Murti, if you go to Dakshineswar, it's not more than 3 feet. She's just standing with 4 legs and 3 feet black stone. But that stone can show the divine or the cosmic experience to Ramakrishna. So when you surrender, even stone can become God. When that intense seeking is not there, even if God comes in front of you, you will ask for ID card. You will ask for ID card. And now you are saying, oh, I am not having a guru. You think living around me is such an easy joke? Ask them, they will tell you. It's not a joke. You understand? Let the seeking become strong. If the seeking becomes strong, even a small stone can teach you. The life can teach you. Life, you see, the prana which is flowing inside my body, coming out as words, the same prana is flowing everywhere. It can straight away enter your body also and create those same strong teachings inside your heart. Please understand, because I have become empty bamboo, hollow bamboo, the air which is flowing inside me, coming out as a flute music. So the same depth, if it can start happening in you, the air which flows inside your nose can become a strong teaching or inspiration inside your heart. Without that intensity, even if I tell something, even if I utter some word, after 2 days you will not even remember. Oh, that young Swami came, as they brought, okay, he spoke something, I think he spoke well. That's all. People come and tell me usually, you spoke well, Swami. I just catch the shirt and tell me what I spoke. He says, no. You spoke well. Don't ask that and all. It's just one more word. A courtesy or socially polite. Or just to get an attention. You can get attention in 2 ways. One by throwing stone, another one by praising. Both ways you can get an attention. A polite way of getting attention. Asking for attention. That's also. I don't think the physical nearness is directly relevant than the intense seeking. The intense seeking is what I feel is needed. Maybe I can use one more word, a psychological revolution, a cognitive shift. Seeing, processing the information which you receive, and decision making. This cognition should completely have a shift. As on now, any experience which you add to your being adds more and more fear or greed. Instead of that, any experience add to your being should become strength and awareness, leading you to more awareness. If this cognitive shift happens, if this psychological revolution happens, I think that is what is Guru. That is what I call Guru. So maybe you can work hard for that than being physically around a master. If your prarabdha is to be physically around a master, suddenly you will see, you will click with somebody. With somebody will click. You won't even have to think about it. People ask me, am I your master? I tell them, as long as this question is there, forget about me. The moment is, if I am your master, that question will just disappear. And you know, you have seen, and the click happens. So, till the click happens, don't bother. If the click does not happen, also don't bother. Just go towards a psychological revolution. If needed, you will have the click when it needed, with whomever it needed. If not, you will achieve the truth as it is. There is no need to bother. And this question, happiness. I can give an honest answer. I can give an honest answer. Or you need, again, socially polite? No. You need an actual honest answer. There is no such thing as happiness. That's the honest answer. Maybe when there is a gap between suffering, you call that as happiness. If you are beaten less number of times by the society and the surroundings, you call that as happiness. It is just a comparative drama. There is only two things in the planet Earth. One is suffering, another one is bliss. Understand? Bliss. Bliss as a positive existence, like a light. Suffering as a negative existence, as darkness. Darkness has no positive existence. Understand? Lightlessness is darkness. So blisslessness is suffering. So bliss as positive existence, suffering as negative existence, means it does not exist. When there is no bliss, suffering. The joy or happiness is a comparative reality. For something can be happy, for something can lead you to happiness, but the same thing can lead the other person into suffering. So happiness is just a comparative reality, the comparative drama. It's only a comparative reality. It's not an existential reality. Please understand, happiness is not existential reality. So according to my experience, there is no such thing as happiness. Either you have suffering or you have bliss. When you have less suffering, you just give little courage to yourself. You need to justify your existence, you see. You need to justify yourself that still why you are not committing suicide. So that is the reason you just tell yourself or console yourself, I have happiness. That is, see all the moments of happiness. Just enquire them. I have seen these guys.